One.
The guy that can have that has the one punch knockout. He's a softball, he's gonna be a very dangerous opponent, you know. So we're gonna have to pull everything out of our hats to win this fight, you know.
Is it gonna be an all-out war with you? I mean,
whatever he gives me, you know, I go out there and if he wants to box, we'll box. If he wants to brawl, we'll brawl. So whatever it is that poses in, or whatever is giving into that situation, will go.
I spent a lot of time focusing on the Asian fighters, you know, out of America, out of Japan, spent time in Japan covering these guys, and the Filipino fighters, and the history of the Filipino fighters is great. I want to know the fight to the death kind of thing with the Japanese fighter. You're aware of that, and that's why I want to know, like,
oh yeah,
what are you going to do to...
Because I think I got part of myself with that type of mentality because, you know, I watched a lot of Japan animation. So growing up, I kind of adopted that mentality of going all out, being a warrior, you know. And of course, seeing the Mexican fighters, it gives me physically and mentally ready for an all-out war. And I know that they are that type of people.
You feel that you have the advantage because of the training that you have with the Mexican and the other great fighters?
Not quite. I mean, he trains hard. He has a lot of sparrings out there, so it doesn't matter where it is. I mean, he trains at the best of his ability, and that's the same with me. You know, it doesn't matter who we go against. It's a matter of preparing ourselves.
Thank you very much.
You go to the Bay Area immediately to train?
Yes, so to train. I will go to the Bay Area to train as hard as I can, to be ready for any fight.
You never train robots?
Sometimes, you know, we will probably go out there sometimes, but Robert usually go and train, but if I have to go down, you know, we'll probably work things out.
But for this fight?
We'll probably be in the Bay Area. Yeah.
Bay Area.
Nishioka is the speed king, you're the Filipino Flash. Who's faster?
That October 13, you guys will find out who's faster, you know. October 13, you guys will find out who is faster, who is stronger. But one thing for sure, we both have speed, we both have power, and it's going to be an exciting fight.
Where do your advantages lie in your mind when you see him on tape?
I think we're the same. We have several advantages. You know, we can say that our speed is our advantage, or our power is our advantage, because it can be at one point. You know, so depends what type of fights is out there and what type of fight is given to us. So
to Nishioka's people.
Yes, I actually offered the Nevada sponsorship. You know, just it's good for boxing. You know, to do a drug testing before the fight, and hopefully that everybody can do it. He said that he's really open to it anyway, so that's good. That's very good. It's a good news.
And for you, it doesn't matter if the other guy
right.
drug tests or not. It's just a friendly, let's be sportsman kind of an offer.
Kind of like that thing. I mean, it's kind of like that. It's more of like, you know, he asks if it's up to him. But I think it's good for the whole sport. It's good for both of us that, you know, we're clean and we're willing to go beyond being a clean fighter and hopefully encouraging other fighters to do the same thing.
I think it's also important, like, you could have done it on the podium, but you decided to do it kind of off to the side, so you didn't put him on the spot, so that it's not an accusatory thing, but it's kind of a brotherhood thing in a sense.
Well, out of respect, you know?
Yeah.
Out of respect, but, you know, that's just how it is. I mean... you know, we're fighters, and he's one of the guys that I respect as a fighter. And he's, you know, he respect me as a fighter, and just to do it the right way. You know?
See, there was a lot of respect today, Rios and Alvarado, and you and Nishioka, but they're going to be intense fights. There's probably not going to be a lot of respect in the ring. Is it because you guys know what you're going to go through?
Well, we respect. As a fighter, we know how difficult fighters are go through.
Yeah.
The difficulties fighters go through. And that's why I respect to put our body, our mind, our lives in that line, you know, for people, for being in that ring, you know, and for the fans, you know. And that's why I respect fighters. Unless they don't respect me, then I can't give any respect back. But you get a guy like Nishioka, who's been dominant in this division, to respect me the way he does, you know, I can only respect him.